فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
The second thing Allah mentioned about Jibreel is عند ذي العرش مكين. What does it mean عند ذي العرش مكين? He has a secured position in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's gathering, or in the gatherings of the angels. And with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Jibreel has a place. له مكان عند الله عز وجل. Jibreel, he has with Allah a big place. He's strong, but he's a humble slave to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is the beauty about a believer. That what he has is the power, the quwwah that is needed, and the tawadu' and the humility and the humbleness that is needed from a slave. He's not arrogant. لِذَلِكَ some people, this is where the problem comes. With power, they come with what? Arrogance. وَلِذَلِكَ عُمَرَ بْنُ الْخَطَّابِ when the Roman leader came to visit him, he had 12 stitches in his garment. And so his companions, they said to him, Umar, we will change your garment, we will give you new clothing, because when they come, they're going to see you, they're going to think this is how we Muslims are. Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu said a very powerful statement. He said, أَعَزَّنَ اللَّهُ بِالْإِسْلَامِ Allah honored us through Islam. فَمَنِ ابْتَغَى الْعِزَّةَ فِي غَيْرِ الْإِسْلَامِ أَذَلَّهُ اللَّهُ Allah honored me not because of the clothing I wear, and not the dressing I wear, the way I dress. Allah honored me through Islam. And anyone who looks for honor in other than Islam, Allah will humiliate him. So there's nothing greater than be a slave to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Nabiullah, Jibreel alayhi salam, he was what? He had quwwah. He was strong. And with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he had a great station. Allah carries on describing for us Jibreel. مُطَاعٍ ثُمَّ أَمِينٍ He is obeyed. Jibreel is obeyed. If Jibreel tells somebody to do something, they obey him. The evidence for that is the hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِذَا أَحَبَّ اللَّهُ عَبْدًا نَادَى جِبْرِيلًا If Allah loves a slave, he called Jibreel. He said, Jibreel, come. From all of the angels, which one does Allah call? Jibreel. Allah says, come, Jibreel. Allah says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ فُلَانًا فَأَحِبَّهُ Allah loves so and so, so love him, Jibreel. فَيُحِبُّهُ جِبْرِيلُ Jibreel starts to love you. فَيُنَادِي جِبْرِيلُ فِي أَهْلِ السَّمَاءِ Then Jibreel, because the inhabitants of the Sama, they obey him, he goes to them. They obey him. مُطَاعٍ Jibreel is obeyed. It's his job to talk to them, they will all listen to him. So Jibreel goes back to the other angels that are in the Sama. And then what does he tell them? He says to them, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ فُلَانًا Allah loves that individual, فُلَان ibn فُلَان فَأَحِبُّهُ Love, all of you guys love him. فَيُحِبُّهُ أَهْلُ السَّمَاءِ All of them will say, نَعَمْ جِبْرِيلُ Okay. And they all start to love that individual. ثُمَّ يُوضَعُ لَهُ الْقَبُولَ فِي الْأَرْضِ And then Allah places acceptance on the earth for that person. The ummah just love that person. Wherever they see him, Allah, فُلَان, Wallahi, I love him. He's not paid for your bills. He's not paid your electricity, your gas, nothing. He's not done you one favor. But when you see him, you feel enslaved to him. You love him. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed on the earth for him al-qabula fil ardi, acceptance on the earth. So what do we want from the hadith? I mean, what are we taking from the hadith? That Jibreel, look the way he's obeyed. Muta'in thamma amin. Jibreel is a person who Allah entrusted with the greatest thing that a person can be entrusted with. What is it? Wahi. And with great responsibility. With great responsibility. When a person carries a responsibility that great, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he brings about respect if he fulfills the responsibility that is given to him. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَمَا صَاحِبُكُمْ بِمَجْنُونَ And your companion is not at all mad. Who is the companion that Allah is speaking about here? وَمَا صَاحِبُكُمْ And your companion. It means وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ نَبِيُّ اللَّهِ مُحَمَّدٌ الَّذِي لَازَمَكُمْ أَكْثَرَ 40 عَامًا نَبِيُّ اللَّهِ مُحَمَّدٌ who was consistent with you for 40 years. He was with you. He stayed with you. You know what house he entered. You knew where he came out from. You knew where he slept. You know his ins and his outs. Nabiullah Muhammad. 40 years. Allah wanted them to know who he is. For 40 years before he was made a prophet, get to know this man. It's not like he randomly came out of nowhere and he said, I'm a prophet of Allah. For 40 years he was a resident amongst you. He lived with you. He stayed with you. This individual you've known for 40 years, that you called him nothing else except Sadiqul Amin, the trustworthy, the truthful one. He's not Majnoon. He's not crazy. This one's not crazy. This shows you something. That the people will praise you for 20 years. They will praise you for 30 years. They may even praise you more than that. They'll give you years of praise. But once you come with مَا يُخَالِفُ هَوَاهُمْ that which goes against their desires. And that's what that which is not in line with it. What do you become? Yesterday, which you were what? جَبَلٌ أَشَمْ You were the mountain that could not be moved. Today you become what? أَضَلُّ مِنْ حِمَارِ أَهْلِهِ You become more misguided than the donkey. And more ignorant than the donkey. وَمَنْ ذَا الَّذِي تُرْضَى سَجَايَاهُ كُلُّهَا كَفَى الْمَرْءِ نُبْلًا أَنْ تُعَدَّ مَعَايِبُ Who is the person who you're going to be pleased with everything about them? But what is honorable about a person is that the mistakes of theirs can be counted. But when I say that the mistakes can be counted, it does depend on what the mistake is. Sometimes a person could do 10 mistakes and it's light. And sometimes a person could do one mistake and it's a big mistake. So it doesn't matter on the mistake. But the point of the matter here is, Nabiullah Muhammad, who they knew who he was, they understood him, they knew his biography, they chose to what? They chose to accuse him of something he was free from by saying that Nabiullah Muhammad is what? He's Majnoon. He's crazy. Alayhi salatu wassalam. So Allah freed him from that accusation. And Allah said, وَمَا صَاحِبُكُمْ Nabiullah Muhammad, he's not Majnoon. He's not one who's even been possessed by a jinn. He's not. Rather, he is one who is coming with a revelation. He's coming with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enslaved him with. Alayhi salatu wassalam. وَلَقَدْ رَآهُ بِالْأُفُقِ الْمُبِينِ And he has already, Nabiullah Muhammad, he has already seen Jibreel in the clear horizon. بِالْأُفُقِ الْمُبِينِ is the clear horizon. Nabiullah Muhammad, he saw Jibreel. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is swearing that Jibreel, Nabiullah Muhammad, that he saw Jibreel ala suratihi al-malakiyah. He saw him in his form as an angel. Fi ufuq al-sama' al-wadih. He saw him high above in the sky, in the form which Allah created him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how many wings did he give to Jibreel? 600 wings. Jibreel had what? 600 janah. He had 600 wings. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he allowed Nabiullah Muhammad to see Jibreel in his form. When you study the angels and you learn about the angels and you learn what their characteristics are, you realize that Allah doesn't need us. Allah does not need us. Allah has a creation who never disobey him. لا يعصون الله ما أمره ويفعلون ما يؤمرون. They never disobey Allah. يسبحون الليل والنهار لا يفطرون. Day and night they are in a state of prostration. They are glorifying Allah. They are exalting him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you give a sadaqah or you pray two rak'ah, what do you think of yourself? You think I should be taken to Jannah right now. Sah? This is the way that shaitan has fooled us. When you study the angels, your iman increases. You realize what type of creation Allah has. Allah has no need of you. Allah does not have any need of you. He has already a creation who were made and they were created in a form of ibadah. They are true slaves of Allah. They are true slaves of His. So no one needs you. The person you're doing a favor is your own bone your flesh, your skin. Do yourself a favor by not taking your bones and your flesh to the hellfire. Don't do anybody a favor. Do yourself a favor. Are you with me, brothers? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has this great noble angel, Jibreel. And Allah allowed Nabiullah Muhammad to see Jibreel. وَلَقَدْ رَآهُ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has already allowed Nabiullah Muhammad to see Jibreel in the clear horizon. Can Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be seen? Did Nabiullah Muhammad see Allah? Nabiullah Muhammad, he did not see Allah with his eyes. Nabiullah Muhammad, he did not see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his eyes. So what he saw was who? He saw Jibreel. That's what he saw. And inshallah ta'ala, when we come to Surah An-Najm, we will deal with the issue of, did Nabiullah Muhammad see Allah or did he not? And the statement of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. Then Allah says, وَمَا هُوَ عَلَى الْغَيْبِ بِضَنِينَ And Nabiullah Muhammad is not a withholder of knowledge of the unseen. Nabiullah Muhammad is not bakhil, he's not stingy. Alaykum on you. The word bidhanin, the mufassirin have two views regarding what is meant by bidhanin. The first view is bidhanin means a bakhil, he's not stingy. That's one view. The second one is bidhanin means muttaham, a person who's suspected. Nabiullah Muhammad is not one who should be suspected. So pay attention here. This ayah is very powerful. Allah here is saying, وَمَا هُوَ Nabiullah Muhammad is not. عَلَى الْغَيْبِ بِضَنِينَ Nabiullah Muhammad is not one who withholds information that was given to him. Allah sends a revelation to Nabiullah Muhammad. And then Allah says to him, convey this message on my behalf. Nabiullah Muhammad is not one who withholds this information and chooses not to share it. He will tell us everything we need to know. And you guys know the famous hadith that Al-Imam al-Tabarani narrated in his Mu'jam, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, ma min amalin yuqarribukum ila al-jannah wa yuba'idukum min al-nari illa waqad buyyina lakum. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that there is no action, there is nothing that will get you closer to Jannah and that will distance you from the hellfire except that it was clarified to you. There is no path, there is no road that will take us closer to Allah, that will bring us nobility and will bring us back our honor that we're looking for, except it was told to us. Except that it was informed of us, we were told about it. That's why Abu Dharr al-Ghifari radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, لَقَدْ تُوُفِّيَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ وَمَا طَائِرٍ يُقَلِّبُ جَنَاحَيْهَا إِلَّا ذَكَرَ لَنَا مِنْهُ عِلْمًا Abu Dharr al-Ghifari, he said that the Prophet died and there is not a bird that flaps its wing in the sky except he told us something about it. The Prophet went as far as telling his companions about the bird. Did he not say in the famous hadith Tirmidhi narrated, لَوْ أَنَّكُمْ تَوَكَّلْتُمْ عَلَى اللَّهِ حَقَّ تَوَكُّلِهِ If you guys relied on Allah the way He deserves to be relied on, لَرَزَقَكُمْ كَمَا يَرْزُقُ الطَّيْرِ Allah will provide for you the way He provides for the bird. يَغْدُو خِمَاسَ وَتَرُوحُ بِطَانًا The bird leaves with an empty stomach, and what does it do? It comes back with a full stomach, and it comes back with food for its children. The bird, we're being told about the bird and the way it is. Salman al-Farisi, a man came to him and he said, عَلَّمَكُمْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ Your Prophet told you guys about everything, huh? Even when you go to the toilet, how to do the call of nature. He told you that? And he said, yes. Our Prophet told us everything. There's nothing that we needed to know. Even if we go to the toilet, he taught us that we should use what? ثَلَاثَةَ أَحْجَارِ Three stones. That we shouldn't use less than that. He told us, عليه الصلاة والسلام, أَلَّا نَسْتَقْبِلَ الْقِبْلَ وَأَلَّا نَسْتَدْبِرْهَا That we don't face towards the Qibla and that we don't face away from the Qibla. He told us everything. When you go to the toilet, the thing that many people don't want to talk about, he told you how to clean yourself from your call of nature. Is he not then going to tell us how the ummah can regain their honor? He won't tell us that. He will tell us about the call of nature and he would discard and he would dismiss how the ummah can regain its honor. Would he dismiss that, brothers? Do you think he would dismiss that? Wallahi, he wouldn't. Nor would he dismiss telling us if we need to celebrate something. He would say, celebrate this. Sah? Would he not? He's telling us a call of nature. Then he will tell us everything that will bring us any deed that we do, we need. He will tell us. He wouldn't hide it from us. This ayah is telling you, وَمَا هُوَ عَلَى الْغَيْبِ بِضَنِينَ. Nabiullah Muhammad, his job, his role was what? What was it that Allah wanted from him? The day that he came out, what did Allah command him? قُمْ فَأَنذِرْ وَرَبَّكَ فَكَبِّرْ وَثِيَابَكَ فَطَهِرْ. What was he told? Stand up and warn. That was his job. From that day when قُمْ فَأَنذِرْ came, Nabiullah Muhammad, that was his mission. He started. يَا أَيُّهَا الرَّسُولُ بَلِّغْ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ. Nabiullah Muhammad, convey that which is upon you. وَإِنْ لَمْ تَفْعَلْ فَمَا بَلَّغْتَ رِسَالَةً. If you do not convey this message and you don't give what you're being told to give on, then you haven't done your job. This is his job. بَلَاغ, and to convey, is his job. So anything we find that has come and we see it later, we see people doing it. If we don't find it in the Quran and the Sunnah, what should we automatically say? That this will not take us to Jannah and it will not distance us from the Hellfire. Sah? That's the qa'idah. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the way he used to teach, he was a great teacher alayhi salatu wa sallam. Sometimes he would teach verbally, he would say things. Sometimes he would stand up and he would show it. Like how he taught us to pray. The Prophet, he stood on the pulpit. And he stood and he said, Allahu Akbar. And he prayed. And so the companions could look at him praying alayhi salatu wa sallam. And then he would come down backwards on the pulpit. And then he would go up. And when he wants to do sujood, the Prophet would come down and he would do sujood on the ground. And then when he finished the salah, he would say to them, Sallu kama ra'aytumuni usalli. Pray the way you saw me pray. He would do it physically so they can learn. So one day what he did was, he took a twig. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he took this twig and he made a straight line on the earth. He's trying to teach practically. He made a line on the earth. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, هذا سبيل الله. This is Allah's path. This is the straight path. And then the Prophet made lines on the right. And then he made lines on the left. And then said, all of these paths that have gone from the right and the left, each and every road there is upon it a deviated individual or a shaitan on top of that path calling the people to it. But the path of Allah is that straight one. And there are other paths that are trying to take away from that path. They're on the right and they're on the left. And then the Prophet recited the ayah, وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوا. This is my path, follow it. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَلْ سَبِيلِي ذَلِكُمْ وَصَّاكُمْ بِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Don't follow these deviated paths. So this is him telling you, I have conveyed the message for you. This is what I'm upon. This is the path where I am on, alayhi salatu wasalam. And he told us that the day of judgment, a people will not take his path. And so he's going to be at the fountain and he's going to see a people. And then when he sees those people, he lays eyes on them. They will be told. They will be told to walk away from the fountain. Just like the camels are told to go away from a land that's not theirs. Grass that's not theirs. Shoo, it's not yours. They will be shooed away. So when the Prophet will then say, my followers, my people, my ummah. And then they will say to him, إِنَّكَ Nabiullahi Muhammad, إِنَّكَ لَا تَدْرِي مَا أَحْدَثُ بَعْدَكَ. You don't know what these people introduced after you. What they brought about. And then the Prophet would say, سُحْقًا سُحْقًا. Distance them from me. Distance them from me even more. Because he left them upon a path. He made them, he drew it for them. How much more did they want? He said, this is my path. He drew it for them. He said, stay on this. And don't take these paths. And what did they do? They took other than his path, alayhi salatu wasalam. So, وَمَا هُوَ النَّبِيُّ اللَّهِ Muhammad is not عَلَى الْغَيْبِ بِضَلِيمِ. He is not one who withholds the knowledge and the revelation that was passed on to him, alayhi salatu wasalam, and he conceals it from the people. He's not one who will do that. وَمَا هُوَ. And the Qur'an is not بِقَوْلِ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. The Qur'an is not the word of a devil expelled from the heaven. The Qur'an is not. This Qur'an is what? It's the speech of Allah. And it's not the speech of a devil which was expelled from paradise and heaven. Allah says in the Quran, وَإِنْ أَحَدٌ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ اسْتَجَارَكَ فَأَجِرُهُ حَتَّى يَسْمَعَ كَلَامَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ أَبْلُغُهُ مَأْمَنًا. If a disbeliever asks for shelter and he wants, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, give it to him until he hears the verses of what? The words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the Quran is what? It's the speech of Allah. It is not the speech of shaitan al-rajim. It's not. Then Allah asks a question. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So before I move on, there are pronouns that are used in this surah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, وَمَا هُوَ بِقَوْلِ شَيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. This وَمَا هُوَ, this هُوَ is a pronoun. Who is it referring back to? And who is it going back to? It is going back to the verse before that, the verse to come, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا ذِكْرٌ لِلْعَالَمِينَ. That this is a reminder to the world, meaning it's referring to the Quran. But what about وَلَقَدْ رَآهُ, that ha, who, in this pronoun, who is it referring to? Nabiullah Muhammad. He's the one who saw Jibreel. وَلَقَدْ رَآ مُحَمَّدٌ جِبْرِيلَ. Nabiullah Muhammad, he saw Jibreel. وَمَا هُوَ, this huwa عَلَى الْغَيْبِ بِضَنِينَ, who is that referring to? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمَا هُوَ عَلَى الْغَيْبِ بِضَنِينَ. Then brothers, this fa'idah I want you to take with you is very important. The Qur'an, the groups that have become deviated in reading the Qur'an and misunderstanding the Qur'an, if you look at them, they get confused, and what makes them misguide is not knowing what the pronoun goes back to. They will take an ayah from the Qur'an, and you then say to them, who does this pronoun go back to? Who is it talking about? And because they don't know what the pronoun goes back to, they apply it on whatever their desires tells them as to be the dhamir in which they're going to take it back to. So it's very important when you're reading the Quran to know what? That you learn the what? You learn the pronouns and the dhamair, where they go back to. Allah then says, فَأَيْنَ تَذْهَبُونَ. Where are you heading? Where are you going to go? Why would Allah ask this ayah, فَأَيْنَ تَذْهَبُونَ? After everything has been clarified to you, and the hujjah and the proof has been established on you, my beloved brothers and sisters, فَأَيْنَ تَذْهَبُونَ? Where are you then going? What path are you going to tread on? After this idah, after this bayan, after this clarification has been brought to you, عَلَى صِدْقِ الْقُرْآنِ, that the Qur'an is truly from Allah, and this Qur'an is not the speech of anyone other than Allah, then where are you going to go? What other path are you going to tread on? This is the question that Allah asks, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah says, إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا ذِكْرٌ لِلْعَالَمِينَ. It is not except a reminder to the worlds. This Qur'an is a reminder to the one whose heart is alive. And it's a reminder to this whole world. But as the poet said, لَقَدْ أَسْبَعْتَ لَوْ نَادَيْتَ حَيًّا وَلَكِنْ لَا حَيَاتَ لِمَنْ تُنَادِي وَلَوْ أَنْفَقْتَ فِي النَّارِ أَضَاءَتْ وَلَكِنَّكَ تَنْفُقُ فِي الرَّمَادِ. Sometimes when you speak, it's like you're speaking to dead ears. Dead people who don't hear. The Quran is given a reminder, but does it actually go into your heart? Does it sink in? As Allah said in Surah Qaf, إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَذِكْرَى لِمَنْ كَانَ لَهُ قَلْبٌ أَوْ أَلْقَى السَّمْعَ وَهُوَ شَهِيدٌ. That this is a reminder, but it will only be a reminder for a person who has a heart which is alive, that will take on these reminders. إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا ذِكْرُ لِلْعَالَمِينَ. This Quran is not except a reminder for you, the ins and the jinn. Then Allah says, لِمَنْ شَاءَ مِنْكُمْ أَنْ يَسْتَقِيمُ. For whoever wills among you to take a right course, this Qur'an would be it for it. If you're a person who wants to attain istiqama and wants to become steadfast and upright, then this Qur'an would provide that for you. لِمَنْ شَاءَ مِنْكُمْ. From whoever amongst you wants to be steadfast, then this Qur'an is a reminder for you, and it's a way and a path for you to be steadfast and for you to gain what is needed from you. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he concludes by saying, وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ. And you do not will, إِلَّا أَنْ يَشَاءَ اللَّهِ, except that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills. رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. the Lord of the worlds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, here he tells us in the last verse that you will not will except that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala willed. And these two verses at the ending, it's a refutation on a deviated group, a group known as the Mu'tazila, who believe that the slave, he creates his own actions. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not aware of your actions. Allah only sees what you do after you did it. And there's a group that also believe, they are called the Jabariyah. They believe that the slave is like a wind, it's like a leaf on a windy day, that the slave doesn't have a choice. These are the two parties. These are the what? These are the two parties. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created your action and He also gave you subhanahu wa ta'ala a will. But this issue of al-qadr and the maratib al-qadr and the levels of qadr, we will leave it for another time and another place. We'll conclude there inshallah ta'ala with Surah Al-Takwir. Anything which I have said that was wrong is from me as shaitan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. أستغفرك وأتوب إليه.